Himanshu Agarwal, co-founder and director, CEO of Aspiring Minds. Aspiring Minds is a four-year-old organization, started 2008, close to completing 5 years very soon. In the space of employability evaluation, Aspiring Minds as an organization has been working with college students across the country, having worked with close to a million odd college students as of now, helping them understand how employable they are and helping them connect to jobs around the country. On the other hand, we work with very large corporates, large as well as small corporates, helping them identify the right talent for their needs, helping them recruit right, and helping them locate talent from across the country in a cost-effective and efficient manner. So Aspiring Minds, you know, is dominantly a technology product company. We build high-end talent evaluation tools, or what people call assessments, in a variety of areas, helping with the core aim of being able to match people to jobs. We work with a variety of industries, starting from the IT, ITES industry, which has been, you know, a mainstay of the middle income groups in India, to working with the retail industry, with banking, finance, with pharmaceuticals, and so on. Helping these industries evaluate and understand what kind of talent would actually succeed for them, and creating an automated, you know, standardized, objective way to make that determination. The same technology has been then, you know, taken to consumers, you know, students who are in our colleges across the country. There are close to 25,000 odd colleges in India, producing over 6 million odd students every year. So helping these students understand how employable they are for a variety of job opportunities, and if they are employable, helping them connect to opportunities across the country. So if I would go back a bit, across the country does not produce employable talent. And that's a challenge which not only the industry is worried about, but the government is extremely concerned about, and been trying to invest a lot of money and effort into doing, into bridging that. So traditionally, to solve this problem, both industry, government, and entrepreneurs have created a variety of mechanisms to bridge the gap. And these typical mechanisms are more and more training. It could be setting up new colleges, it could be setting up new curriculums, setting up vocational training, setting up job-oriented courses, and the likes. So at Aspiring Minds, we took a different view to it. And we said that while that is all important, it is very important to understand what people lack in, and have a fair and objective mechanism to really say that, look, this is why you are not really fit for a job. Just branding someone as not employable does not really help that person. So a mechanism which can help you actually objectively say that this is the reason why this person is not really good for a job, and if he does this, this is what is going to help him become employable, and actually meet people's aspirations. For example, you could make someone employable for a call center, but probably aspirationally this person wants to be a banker. So what is it that makes him qualify for a call center, and what is lacking in this person to become a banker? So the entire context of Aspiring Minds started with the idea of, can we create a mechanism to evaluate how people, if people are employable, and if they are not employable, be able to objectively tell them that these are the reasons why you are not employable. So that is where we came up with this entire idea of AMCAT, which is a flagship evaluation tool. So far, you know, over 1 million people have taken this tool in the last 4 years. This year, we're looking at adding another 1 million users of AMCAT. What the assessment basically does is, so it's like, you know, a typical test. The only difference is it's a completely automated adaptive solution, which actually asks questions based on your previous answers, trying to understand what you're good at and what you're bad at. And this tool evaluates a variety of competencies, your language skills, your aptitude, your personality, your knowledge of particular subject areas, going into depths of spoken English, for example. And the idea, post the test, so it's a 3-hour automated computer-based test, post the test, the candidate gets a detailed report about his or her strengths and weaknesses, how well he or she fits into particular job roles, what kind of industries would he most suit for, and so on. So this detailed report helps the person understand how employable he or she is, and look at either the right kind of jobs or the right kind of training to become more employable. So that is how AMCAT got set up, and today, you know, it is delivered in over 25 states in the country. You know, every month close to 30,000 odd students are currently taking the AMCAT. So today, close to 150 corporations work with Aspiring Minds using the AMCAT, in using it to evaluate talent and reaching talent across the country. These vary from, you know, top 6 of the 10 IT companies in the country use it, top 2 BPOs in the country use it, large banks, insurance companies, retail organizations are using AMCAT to evaluate talent and reach out talent across the country. Close to 150 organizations today which use the AMCAT to evaluate talent, put together offering close to 50,000 jobs every year. So the basic idea was that AMCAT today acts as a way to bridge between what the industry needs and making an objective way to tell, you know, our student community, this is what the industry needs, this is what you need to get better at, and creating a bridge for the students to migrate into the mainstream industry once they think they are employable and qualified to do that. We measure opportunity based on the impact we can create. So to give you an idea, close to 6 million students pass out from colleges across the country. So that is and that is the set of people who every year come out and look for jobs. So that is the opportunity size if I look at the consumer side. And these are just if you're talking about people who are graduates. On the other hand, there's a large population, at least 3 to 4 times this population, which after they plus two look for jobs, which is a lot in the area of the where the NSDC, for example, today is working in the National Skill Development Corporation, trying to look at skilling people to become job ready, who may or may not be actually graduates or qualified, for typical white collar jobs. So the opportunity on that size is, you know, as aspiring minds, our aim is to touch these, first aim is to touch these 6 million people and help them, you know, give them the feedback which they require. You know, I have seen in tier 1 cities, people have a challenge in understanding what their kids should do, or what students have no clue where they fit and what kind of opportunities are there for them. And when you go to tier 2, tier 3 cities, the gap is so wide that people spend years just to figure out where they should be or what they should be doing. And that is just, you know, lack of information. So that is where we see an opportunity of AMCAT being a scalable, automated mechanism to translate that information to people. So that is, you know, on the if I look at on the consumer side. On the business side, Indian industry is growing at a decently good pace. You know, it's not as strong as it was probably a couple of years back, but there is still, you know, a lot of growth which is expected. And most industry, you know, the well-established industry is hiring anywhere between 10 to 20% of their workforce year on year. On the other hand, the new greenfield industries like retail, pharma, which is, you know, getting into tier 5, tier 6, tier 7 towns, are hiring at much higher pace. And all these industries, when you're looking at very large scale a very large scale recruitment, really need to establish objectivity when they come to recruit people. And that is where Aspiring Minds plays a, you know, great role. Aspiring Minds, you know, the last 4 years have been very exciting. Pretty much doubled year on year, and we continue to look to double in pretty much all parameters as we've been doing. So in the coming years, you know, Aspiring Minds basically has a three-axis strategy of how what we want to do and how we want to grow. So one is to reach out to more and more roles and industries. So if I look at my journey, you know, we started with the IT industry, and that was where we only played, and today we've entered two more sectors, and in the next couple of years we look at, you know, pretty much being available in every sector. So on the B2B side, on the business side, we are establishing AMCAT and its suite of products for a variety of industry. On the consumer side, you know, we started with engineers, and that has been a mainstay. And more recently, we've started graduating into degree colleges, people who've done the BCOMs, BSCs, BAs, and so on. Very soon, we are looking at, you know, diploma engineers, ITI students, 10 plus 2. So we are looking at being taking this opportunity more to the bottom of the pyramid for students of all kinds of calibers. And lastly, and which we think is, you know, the core, you know, the backbone of Aspiring Minds, it's technology. So we have always been a front runner in assessment technology. We pretty much compete with anyone in the world when it comes to the kind of assessment technology we've developed and deployed. We continue to innovate in that. We are looking at, you know, more phenomenally better ways to evaluate talent. Very recently, we launched a spoken English evaluation, which could automatically evaluate how good you speak English. There's certain, similarly, we've launched a tool which can automatically evaluate how good you can program. You know, you can actually write a program. And so something which has become very useful for the computer, the IT industry, the IT product industry. So our capability to innovate into technology and bringing out more and more valuable products in the assessment space is the third area where we are looking at continuing to invest and grow in. A big focus has changed from addressing Western markets and setting up businesses in India which would address Western markets to setting up businesses which would address Indian markets. So in the last 5 years, I would say that, you know, more startups have come up which are looking at, you know, what we call Brand India, right? Looking at how do you remove inefficiencies in the Indian system, be it logistics, be it, you know, retail, you know, online retail, be it marketing, be it product development. So in the last 5 years, I think that's been a big shift. You know, if you look at probably the decade and a half before that, it is dominantly businesses coming up which would target American markets or the European markets, build, and you know, it has produced great results. You could see a huge, the IT industry pretty much, you know, 20 years back were all startups. So today I think that's been a very big shift as I see it on entrepreneurship. And India, you know, if I look at Aspiring Minds and if I look at how we've been seeing it, you know, which is typically inside, I think what I see is a lot of ambitious young minds, you know, a lot of people, a lot of aspirations. So today, you know, aspirations are not limited to metro cities. Aspirations, you know, being able to work in the mainstream, being not looking for the only government job out there, but looking at coming into the private industry, migrating from an IT industry centric country to, you know, banking, finance, media and other. So we're seeing that people are a lot more aspirational and are looking to get into the mainstream industry. So the young demographic dividend is very vibrant. You know, today people ask questions, people are looking, you know, we get so many queries from small towns which look at, look, I'm not interested in working for a big brand. I want to work for a company we can learn more. You know, smaller companies, you know, companies which are doing different kind of work. So I think so the aspiration, ambition, I think is a clear, you know, clear value which I can see in Brand India today. You know, people are wanting to work hard, wanting to explore and are ambitious, you know, and that's changed phenomenally over the last 20 to 30 years. You know, 30 years back, government jobs or, you know, a so-called big conglomerate job was what everyone would look for. But today, you know, people are ready to explore. People are keen to explore actually and aspirationally wanting to do good and grow fast. So that's clearly there. Indian education system is always considered amazingly good. You know, if I look at engineering, you know, the IITs, the IIMs, doctors, you know, India's probably been a source of, you know, providing great talent to the world. And that's what, you know, I've spent a few years in the US and that's what was appreciated. You know, you would get a lot of respect for the kind of education and learning India would provide to the industry. I think that's, over the last 10 to 15 years, I think that's what the outside world looks at India for, you know, smart people and a lot of investment coming into India when they're looking at servicing abroad is for the kind of talent India today possesses. So the education system, you know, Brand India and education, I think go very well to the outside world. And I think India has done a great job in building capacity, for example, in education. The policy of non-interference by the government, especially in the private sector, has done well. You know, that's where, you know, industry has been able to choose, pick and retain talent the kind they would like. And I think that's worked very well. More recently, you know, where we see, you know, the entire initiative the government is doing on the national skill development side with the NSDC, the corporation coming up and helping organizations train more and more people. We see that, you know, as a policy helping a lot in building Aspiring Minds business and the overall, you know, education ecosystem. I think the core focus of investing in the ecosystem and letting private players be able to do good is what I think has really worked well so far for the Indian education system and has been a, you know, boon for Aspiring Minds as well.